play and call it work.
Yeah, the Skaven, as they try to charge into the town, not really pushing them back, actually more like slowing them down. But they still have to retreat back into the keep. So we have our elves back in on the little fortress and the last defended stronghold in this town as the Skaven get ready to storm the walls. And that's the battle plan we're going to do right now, storm the walls. So Gwyn is back in, obviously, for this battle plan. We have Skaven versus High Elves. Let's look at the scenario and the rules for the battle plan and then the armies we brought. All right, battle plan, storm the wall from the Mighty Battles rule, or Mighty Battles of the Age of Undying War book. So we have a wall that's going to be deployed on the side of the table, and all Skaven will be charging into the wall. They will be the attackers, but in this scenario, we're going to switch the special command abilities. So the attacker's supposed to get the Rousing Chant, but the defender's going to get that. And the defender's supposed to get Animate Infernal Guardian. So basically the scenario is about a Chaos Keep being attacked, but we're having a High Elf Keep, so we're going to switch. So the Skaven will have the ability to summon in some demons, while the High Elves, the defenders, will be able to add plus one to the hit rolls and bravery characteristics. So right now I'm going to explain this exactly. Rousing Chant. Normally the attacker's ability, the High Elf General, if you use the ability, all units in the army within 12 of the general at the start of the time he uses this chant, add one to the hit rolls as well as their bravery characteristics until their next hero phase. High Elves having a lot of bows on the ramparts of the walls, probably a pretty good command ability for them. And the Skaven will get Animate Infernal Guardians. The general calls upon the demonic creatures to help him to victory. If your general uses this ability, you can set up a unit of 2d6 demons within 12 of the fortress and more than 3 from the enemy. And the count is moving. All models must have 1 or 2 wounds. So this scenario is very simple. We're going to place 3 objectives behind the walls. Me as a defender place the first one, then Gwyn places one, then I place one. And the Skaven basically got to control the objectives, meaning they basically overwhelm the walls, get into the fort, and control it. The High Elves, being the defenders, must deploy their entire army first, and the attackers will get first turn. For victory conditions, if the defender, that's me, controls all 3 objectives, I get a major victory. If I control 2 objectives, I get a minor. If the attacker wins a major, if I only control 1 siege objective, the attacker wins a minor victory. So Gwyn doesn't even have to control them, just get me off them. If the defender controls no siege objectives and the attacker controls at least 1, the attacker wins a major victory. So that's, well, pretty good for the Skaven. Just probably push me off the objective and get on them if they can. So we have already deployed for the scenario. We're about to go and Gwyn will pick who gets first turn, but I think the attackers are definitely going to want first turn. So right now, let's look at the armies in this battle plan.
20 Phoenix Guard and Anointed of Assyrian are holding the main gates. 20 Spearmen next to them outside the gates. On the walls we have 1, 2, 3, 4 units of 6 archer teams. A prince with the Phoenix banner. 20 more Spearmen inside the gates. A single bolt thrower on this tower. And we have some Shadow Warriors off on the flank.
Starting on that side, I have my Warlock Engineer, I have my Warp Lightning Cannon, the first of my 2 Warp Fire Throwers, a large group of 30 Clan Rats with Scaling Ladders, another Warp Fire Thrower. Here's my favorite Hellpit Abomination. I didn't bring him out yesterday, but I will today. Packmaster for him. I've got a bunch of Storm Vermin and my Warlord back to life under here. And back here, I have a Verminlord Deceiver and Deathmaster Snitch.
Skaven turn 1, hero phase.
My Warlord in here is going to summon some Horrors of Tzeentch.
Getting 2d6. Ooh, 7.
Now that they're out, they're going to cast Arcane Bolt at this unit of archers.
Looking for a 5.
No. Snake Eyes. All right, he's going to do a Fire and Forget move on Deathmaster Snitch with Skitter Leap. I need a 3 to get it off. Good.
Teleporting Deathmaster all the way across the field, right onto the walls.
That's going to cast Mystic Shield on the Clan Rats.
I'm getting plus 1 save on the Clan Rats.
I'm going to plant my standard this turn so that this unit is immune from Battle Shock.
Going on to the move phase. War's going to run. Far. Stormvermin running next. 9 inches. Actually going 11 because their musician makes them run plus 2. Hiding behind the big building. Clan Rats are also going to run. Going 11 inches. Running the Warlock. 9 inches.
9 inches. So he's going to go here.
Both Warfighters are going to run.
Rolling for the one over there. It's a 4.
10 inches on this one and the other one. 12 inches. Running and hiding up with the unit and hiding behind the little tower here. Warplane Ken is going to move around the tower. Help Abomination is going to run. Not very far. And he moves 2d6 for a total of 8 inches. Running the... I heard what he's called. Packmaster? There we go. Behind the wall, close to the Help Abomination.
Yep.
And this guy's going to wait back here to teleport next turn. Moving on to the shooting phase.
The Warp Lightning Cannon is going to shoot these elves.
So we're rolling a first die for power, is it?
My target die, so I've got to equal or beat this. Ooh, so they take 6 more
they're
wounds.
They take 6 more wounds. So what happens now is this now rolls 6 dice. For every die that's equal to or higher than the 1, they take a mortal wound. So that's the best roll you can get. Pink horse, no shooting to the spearman.
Need 4s and 4s.
Ooh, all hitting. 4's the wound. 3. Spearman have a 5-up save. Rerolling 1s and 2s in the shooting phase. For 2 dead. We're going to kill these two.
Deathmaster Snitch is going to start attacking these archers, throwing his poison throwing stars. 3s and 4s. They all hit.
Ooh, all hitting.
4s. Only 1 wound. 1 wound. No rend.
6-up save and cover? Nope. I'm going to kill this one.
This guy.
Charge phase. Deathmaster's going to tear a charge.
He
makes it with an 8. Right into my archers.
Deathmaster is going to attack these guys. He's looking for 3s and 3s with a minus 1 rend and d3 damage. So kind of a Cuisinart. 4 hits.
So
and 3 wounds.
6-up save. Hey, we'll take 2 for d3. We're going to lose.
2 guys.
Hey, just 2. I'll take it. We're going to take them from this side. As we pile in, we're going to attack back. 3 attacks back on 5s. And if I roll 2 2s and a 1, he dies instantly. No, he's fine. Dang. Time for battle shock. So these archers here, bravery of 7, or sorry, 6, losing 3 models. Oh, I'm going to lose 2 more. No, my mistake, that's all 3. I can do math.
Minus 6.
No, I can't. 1 guy's still alive. Math is hard. Over here, my spearmen, bravery of 6, 2 died. Actually, bravery of 7, and we're all good.
They're fine.
In my hero phase, he's going to chant and get every unit within 12 of him plus 1 to hit. The mage is going to put Mystic Shield on the Phoenix Guard successfully. The archers here are going to move closer to the Deathmaster, which is going to shoot him down. So mage is going to run 10 inches to here. This one archer from this unit is going to move down to here. Phoenix Guard are going to surge forward. They're not going to try to hold that gate. They're going to run forward and try to kill as many as they can. Whoop. The anointed is going to go through the building, join these guys. My spearmen are also going to go forward, see if we can engage as many things as we can. Shooting! This guy's going to fire first in a Deathmaster here. He's going to use his once per game ability and fire twice. Hitting on fours. No.
That's too bad.
Five of these archers are within six of Deathmaster. Anybody outside of six can't actually target him with shooting. So just these five are going to fire him. And again, once per game ability and firing two shots. 10 shots on threes because they're within 12 of the... Oh no! The chant.
I can live with this.
Oh no! Four's the wound. No! One. Three up save! He does take it. No damage. These guys are here. Are going to fire their once per game ability, double shots. All my archers are going to do that first turn. So they're going to fire into the clan rats. 10 shots on threes. Wounding on fours. Three saves.
Four up right now because of the shield.
We drop two.
Two die. Take two from back here.
I guess the guy who can't target Snitch will actually target the horrors.
This is true.
Threes and fours, nothing. Five guys here can see. Target the clan rats again. 10 shots on threes is my chant. Four's the wound. We got four more saves for the clan rats.
Four saves. They can do this. Ooh. Or they can't.
That kills four.
What?
I want to fire my bolt doors 12 shots into the pink horrors. 12 shots hitting on threes because of the chant. Wounding on threes.
For fives.
Ren, six, looking for sixes.
Sixes.
All so right. Heals five.
That's effective.
That's the end of my shooting, so we're going to charge phase. First, the Phoenix Guard. They're getting a far charge. Wrapping really far all around the clan rats. Able to engage both of the Warpfire Throwers, but not really enough to get attacks on to kill both of them. Spearman and clear charge as well. Going nine. I'm going to choose to do the Phoenix Guard's assault first. This Phoenix Guard here is going to pile in. Is it there?
Mm-hmm.
This one's going to pile around this guy here. And I'm going to do no more movement.
Cool.
That guy there is going to attack the Warpfire Thrower. Hitting on threes. Actually, moving a couple of guys back. Just forgetting to keep my guys within 12 of the banner for the chance. So hitting on twos and wounding on threes. One wound on him with a rend.
So it takes damage. It only has a six save.
Brings him down to two. Now this other Phoenix Guard here is going to do the same thing. The other Warpfire Thrower. Hitting on twos and wounding on threes.
Takes a wound there too.
And brings... him down to two. Leaving me with 16 more attackers, two attacks apiece, plus my champion, hitting on twos into the clan rats.
Love these great handfuls of dice.
Oh, winning on threes. With Mystic Shield and Clan Shield, five of save.
Oops.
That kills 13 of them.
That's a great number. Shall leave you there immune to Battle Shock. Fives and fours.
So the pink horse attacking my spearmen.
Nothing done.
No hits. This archer's gonna stab Deathmaster. But he misses.
Is he's not?
Deathmaster attacks back with his five attacks, hitting on threes.
Threes. Only catching two.
Okay. And wounding on threes.
One.
Six up save. Can you hold? No.
Nope.
No, he's dead. Spearmen are going next.
Mm-hmm.
Spearmen have 21 attacks, hitting on fours. Hey. Four's the wound. Okay, I got enough, I think. Six, five up saves. Oh, we got
nope.
Warfire throws attacking next. Two attacks hitting on fives. And wounding on fives. Three up save because of Mystic Shield. No. And then I ignore a wound on a four plus. No.
Nope.
Pulling this one. Storm of them and then piled in and I'm going to attack my Phoenix Guard. They have two attacks apiece hitting on fours. Four hits. Wounding on threes.
Four wounds. Four wounds.
Running a missing shield for four up save, and then ignoring wounds on a four up, witness of destiny, taking another wound. That's also going to be this guy.
Cool.
Clan rats are piling in next.
Fours, rerolling ones because of this chieftain.
Oh! Clan rats are angry. We
four,
got six,
six hits.
Wounding on fours.
This is where the fours fail.
Oh, three of them still. 3 up save. Oh no. 4 of Witness Destiny. We lose one more. That's gonna kill that dude. Going on to Battle Shock. Clan rats are immune, and these guys are high enough bravery to not take any fleeing from the wounds they cost or lost. So going on to turn 2, let's see who's going first. I'm gonna get a. Oh, I really wanted to go first. Oh well.
I wasn't so worried this time.
Skaven, turn 2.
Set it up to weather the storm or go first.
I actually was really banking on getting 2 turns in a row to kill your Warpfire throwers. I figured I could hold out if I did that.
No.
And now, no.
Phoenix Guard are gonna go away, I think.
Hero phase.
He's gonna wait another round on a Scare Leap, and he's gonna put a Mystic Shield on the Hellpit Abomination.
Alrighty. Getting it. I'm way too far away to unmind that.
This guy's going to pick up his banner so he can catch up with the rest of the horde. Warlock Engineer is going to cast an augmented Warp Lightning Bolt at the Phoenix Guard. So I need a 5. If I get less than 5, he takes mortal wounds. If I get better, you take a d6.
Ouch. You got it. Just. D6 mortal wounds to Phoenix Guard.
You're not in range to unbind on that?
I don't know, I'm pretty far, yeah. 5
mortal wounds.
Phoenix Guard ignore mortal wounds on a 4+. And we're going to take 3. We're going to take 2 here. And 3.
My general is going to put his extra attacks onto these guys here. This guy is going to whip the Hellpit Abomination into a frenzy.
We need Deathmasters 3 inches away from my archers. The Storm Vermin are locked in the combat with the Phoenix Guard here, but they are going to retreat because they do have the ability to charge after retreating.
My Warlord's going to move next. He's just going to scoot up within 3 inches of that unit too, but stay behind the corner. He's just going to shuffle up a bit here, staying safe behind the corner, but clearly seeing you.
Yep. Warlock Engineer's going to run and retreat. 9 inches.
9 inches. Just doing what they do. Getting out of dodge.
Uh-oh.
2d6.
Moving 2d6 on the hill pit. Right,
8. 8 inches. That's enough. I think we both can eyeball this to get within 3 inches of you here.
Absolutely. Going on the far side of the tree instead. Running the Battle Center Bearer.
8 inches. He's vulnerable, but that happens.
Running the Packmaster. Oh, he wants to go fast.
11 inches.
Get him into cover.
And shoot some archers.
Warbody Cannon's coming around the corner. Deathmaster throwing some ninja stars into the archers. Hitting on threes.
Oh, got them all.
Going on threes.
Looking for fours.
Oh, fours are wounded.
Yeah. Nothing.
I likes it. More fire throwers.
Go bigger, go home. More
flame.
Got it. So a d6 mortal wounds.
5 more. Oh no. Ignore mortal wounds on the Phoenix Guard on a 4+. Hey, we take 2.
2.
Where do I need these? Pulling this one and the one that was holding down this warp fire thrower. Other warp fire thrower. More.
So gonna go big and try and wreck your day.
Oh,
does
he
not
does.
Explode. This is a good time for that to happen.
Four more. I'm taking 4 mortal wounds on a 4+. I ignore them. I'm going to lose 2 more. I'm going to take this guy and, let's say this guy. We're putting cans of fire into the archers in the tower. So the power is 6.
Oh.
So now rolling 6 dice, and for every 6 or higher, they take a mortal wound.
So I should get 1.
Ah, you got 1.
I got.
Killed him. That ends Shreem's run of charges. Deathmaster looking for a 3-inch charge. And he gets a 3-inch charge. He's in. Storm Vermin are able to charge even after they retreated. Looking for probably a 3, but 9 will get them in for sure. Like so.
My general's gonna charge too.
Looking for a 3. He gets it.
Yep.
Crashing in. The Hellpit Abomination is charging with a 6.
6.
And failing to charge, not able to get within half an inch because there's Skaven all in the way. Storm Vermin are gonna attack first.
They each have 30 attacks, hitting on 4s, wounding on 3s. Trees.
Spearmen have taken 10 wounds with a 6 up save because of rend. And we re-roll ones for not bad, 7 dead. Phoenix Guard are gonna go next. They're not gonna do any piling in. They are hitting clan rats on 2s because of the chant. Wounding on threes.
Fives.
Five save.
One, save two, three, four. Okay.
Killing six rats. The warlord's gonna go next.
Three attacks, threes with and threes.
The halberd.
Two.
Three's the wound.
One wound.
Six up save. No, there's another one. Barb blade hitting on.
Threes, wounding on fours.
Four hits.
Four hits.
Are those fours the wound? Two. Five save. Rerolling ones. No. One more dies. Let's kill that duder.
Cool.
My archer's gonna go next. Fives to hit. Aye.
Let's see what Deathmaster
can do. He's gonna attack back with his five attacks.
Threes and threes.
Ooh, two hits so far. We hold him, I like it. And two wounds. There's a rend, but I got cover. Okay. Nope, we're gonna lose.
D3.
Two. Oh, yeah.
Oh, okay. Just two of them.
I'll take it.
Sorry.
My spearmen are gonna pile in next. They all have 5-inch threat, basically. They're gonna put all their attacks onto the storm vermin. So this guy's gonna pile in that way and attack him. And take him with him, apparently.
Yep.
One guy on the warlord, hitting on a four, a wounding on a four. He wounds.
Saving on a four.
He's fine. Seven spearmen with eight attacks, hitting the storm vermin, hitting on fours. Good hit. Four's the wound. We got two wounds. Two. Four up save. Ah, they're good.
Nice.
No damage. Battle shock time. So I have bravery essentially nine on these guys, and we lost three, six, seven. Hey, we're good. Nobody flees. Lost nine spearmen. Their bravery eight right now. Ooh, that's
six
a lot.
Six more.
That might be.
No.
Oh, guess not. So we're going to keep him there. Use the musician. Regular guy. He doesn't need to be there no more. Warlord front screw your way. On 4+, he runs away. Archers, bravery of six. Lost two models. Oh no, two more flee. Let's take these two. Bravery four on the clan rats, losing six models.
They are all gone.
Yeah, they're all getting out of there. One more unit. Forgot about this unit over here. They lost a model. One can flee in a six. No, they're good. All right, Heil, turn two. They're going to... my general here is going to chant. My mage is going to try to cast Arcane Bolt onto Deathmaster here. Gets it for D3 mortal wounds. Takes two. Going on the move phase, these archers are going to run and retreat. They're going to move 12 inches. Dropping them there. Going to move my Lore Master to here. Not my Lore Master, my Anointed of Assyrian. My mage is going to run down here. I'm gonna run my spearman 9 inches into this position. Archers are gonna run 9 inches.
Two, right?
These archers are also, they land right there. And then these archers are also gonna run. They're gonna go 11 inches. Running down low. Then my general's gonna run. He's not gonna go that far. He's gonna go 8 inches. There. My Phoenix Guard are engaged by that Warp Fire Thrower, so they are going to run and retreat. Oh no! Oh, they have a musician. Rerolling ones. For 6 or 10 inches. We're running behind the building. And these spearmen are going to stay put. Shooting phase. The Bolt Thrower is going to fire into the Storm Vermin. Hitting on threes because of the chant. Owning on threes. With a four save.
Five up. Two save. Four die.
Going on to combat, my spearmen are going first. I have three models and four attacks. Hitting on fours. Rerolling ones because he did not move in the last movement phase. For one hit, wounding on a four. One wound. They have a four up save. And they get one more.
Boom.
Attacking back with a bunch
three.
Of attacks.
No, three attacks.
Claw their eyes out or gnashing their bones or something.
Gnashing all their bones.
Right. Three attacks per... Storm Vermin there. Hitting on fours, I think.
Yeah.
What's right. going on?
No, I outnumber you now, so hitting on three.
Oh, there you go. Okay.
We got this?
We got it. I think we got it.
Okay.
Decent hits. And winning on threes. Too many. They have a rend, right?
Yeah, minus one.
Six up save because of rends.
Nothing.
Crud. Well, they killed some. I'll take it. And that ends my combat phase. We got Battle Shock. Lost 5, Bravery 5. How many Stormbringer flee?
Two more.
I like it.
1 and 2.
That ends turn 2 with the elves forced to retreat into their fort. Even the mighty Phoenix Guard have backed up away from all the various rat, that thing's scary, monstrosities.
And yeah, that'll get through the door.
That's going to crash right through in a moment. But we're going to turn 3. Who's going to go first? I wouldn't mind having 2 turns in a row.
No.
Oh, I'll take it.
Actually, it's not such a big deal because there's not a lot you can do.
I think I'm going to try and charge with them.
Oh.
See how much work we can get done. My general is going to chant. My mage is going to cast Mystic Shield onto my general. You know what? No, we're going to put it onto the spearmen. Successfully. Plus 1 to their save. My Phoenix Guard are going to run 11 inches. And run into the wall. Going to run my general. That's enough. DM to here. Going to run those archers by the door. Going to stand back here. Actually, running at the front side of the spearmen. These archers are going to run behind them. No problem. So there, and then my spearmen are going to run, and they're going to get, actually, we're going to actually keep them where they were. Keep the king alive. And these archers are going to run. Be 3 inches of the objective.
Yep.
Shooting phase, bolt throwers going to fire into these storm vermin over here, hitting on 3s because of the chant. Oh, wounding on 4s. 5-up save. Drops 3 of them. That's the last of them. Hero phase.
Flamers of Tzeentch.
Yeah, summon some Flamers of Tzeentch with the scenario command ability.
That's 7 of them.
Flamers. Mystic Shield from the Skyre Warlock onto the Abomination successfully. I think I'm out of range.
Yeah, you are.
Skitter Leaping, hitting a 3.
Got it.
I got excited. I saw that 1.
I know. I was worried.
Hello!
No.
We have somebody just teleported in. Or came out of the sewers, whatever he did.
Yeah.
Popped up over here instead.
What's that? He's whipping that into a frenzy.
We have a frenzied hell pit. The Deathmaster's Itch is going to throw his throwing stars into my bolt thrower. 5 attacks on 3s. Or 3 attacks on 3s. 2 hits. Force the wound. 2 wounds. I'll put the wounds on the bolt thrower with a 4-up save. 1 goes through. It's down to 3.
Deceiver.
Deceiver is going to throw his Doomstar into my bolt thrower.
Hits on 3s, wounds on 3s. I always miss.
Yeah, you got it.
Yeah,
you
always give it to me. Yourself. All right.
3s to wound. 3, that's
got
a wound.
It. Minus
5-up save. Yeah, I made it. Flamers are firing their flamey things into my Phoenix Guard, hitting on 4s. 3s to wound. Aye.
Okay.
4-up, armor save. Ooh. That multiplied to D3 wounds each. That's 11 wounds suffered by my unit. So then they ignore those on a 4 plus. We take too many. We take 5. I'm going to take these 5. The warplating can have to fire next, but I forgot to show you all the movement phase. So everything kind of ran forward, obviously, because nothing else in line of sight. And Deathmaster came down over here. So, Warplane Cannon to the Halberdiers. 6 dice. Any 6 is a mortal wound. 1 mortal wound, which they ignore on a 4 plus. No, he gets 1.
How many have died?
Charge phase. The Deceiver's going to clear a charge. Oh, yeah, I think he's in. Always definitely in. Deceiver's attacking my Spearman with his Stiletto. 5 attacks, hitting on 3s. Everything hit, and they're wounding on 2s. 3 wounds. Norseman armor is 3 rend, and it's D3 wounds apiece, so that's 6 guys.
Yeah.
7 guys, I can do math. Here's 2. Seven.
Right.
With that being the only thing in combat, I'm going to have my archers go first. 3 archers in range. Hitting on 5s.
Nice.
Wounding on 5s. We got 1 wound. Do you make a save? 4 save? So I'm going to get 6 spearmen in range to attack with their range. 6 spearmen, 7 attacks, hitting on 4s. Everything hit. On 4s. Oh, 6 wounds. With 4 up saves. He's going to take 4 wounds.
That's good.
All right, I'm going to put my... This is risky. I'm putting my general in as well. Nice. My general, I forgot about my champ, but I don't think it really matters. I think all my Sturman hit. So my general is attacking with 6 attacks, hitting on 3s. Sorry, with the chant hitting on 2s. He's wounding on 4s, though. 3 wounds. Maybe he takes 1 more. I have Battle Shock for my Phoenix Guard over there. And about 1 inch out of range of getting a +2 for being close to my Spearmen. So they are Leadership 7. They lost 6 models. Or Leadership 8. Losing 1. Spearmen lost 3, 6, 7. With Leadership of 7 because of the banner. And they're going to lose 5 more. That ends turn 3. So we got a big turn 4 to see who's going first. I think I got it. I'm definitely going to take it. So my general is going to chant Hero Phase. My mage is also going to put Mr. Arcane Bolt on the Deathmaster. Rolling a 9. Attempting to unbind. No. So Deathmaster takes D3 mortal wounds.
On the Deathmaster?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
He takes 2.
Cool.
Phoenix Guard over here. In the movement phase, we're going to run. Ooh, 1 extra inch. Up top. The move phase, this is going to move forward a little bit. Anointed is going to move 6 inches to here. Shooting, I'm going to start off with these archers here. They're going to fire into the Deceiver. Deceiver is -2 to hit, and my chant makes me +1 to hit. So basically, 5 shots hitting on 5s. We got 3 hits. Wounding on 4s. 2 wounds. 4 up save. Takes 1 more wound. 5 more archers up front. Hitting, actually, I'm going to do the 5 archers there and the 2 archers back there all at the same time. Oh, I can't do that. 2 archers in the back hitting on 6s. 1 hit. The other 5 archers hitting on 5s. For 2 hits, wounding on 4s, no wounds. Both doors in the fire. Let's put 4 shots. Let's put 5 shots into them and the remaining shots into the flamers. 5 shots into that warfare door, hitting on 3s. Wounding on 3s, that's dead.
Oh, -1 range.
Yeah. And then we have 7 more shots into the flamers, hitting on 3s, wounding on 3s. We have 5 wounds on them.
6, have 1 more die.
6 up save, and 4 die. Charge phase, my Anointed of Assyrian is going to declare a charge. He's going to go 5 inches, and I don't know if he'll make it because he has to go around the archers. No. Needed to roll a 6 to make that charge. I'm going to have my spearman going, maybe not. No, I'm going to have my general going first. 6 attacks, hitting the deceiver on 2s. Wounding him on 4s. We got 3. Takes 3 wounds. And he's down to 2. The stiletto is down, the deceiver with the stiletto is attacking my general. 5 attacks, hitting on 3s. 3 hits. Hitting on 4s. 1 wound. I'm getting no save, so it'll be D3 wounds. He'll take 3. He's down to 2. My archers are going to go next. I'm going to get in real tight so that all my spearmen can pile in. 6 attacks for the archers, hitting on 4s because of the chant, which helped. And wounding on 5s. 2 wounds. 4 save. Takes a wound. My spearmen will go next. I'm only able to get those guys into combat anyway, but I might as well just... I'll keep these farther back. 7 attacking, or 6 guys attacking for 7 attacks, hitting on 3s. Oh no! Wounding on 4s. No! He's gonna live! Hero Phase, Skaven, turn 4. Who's he gonna do?
Arcane Bolt on your general.
Arcane Bolt, my general. Rolling a 12. I have no way of unbinding this. So D3 mortal wounds. 2. He's dead. Bring in more flamers with the general's command ability for the scenario.
8 of them this
time. Oh boy. Back on my turn, the flamers, or whatever these guys are called, they couldn't have fled because they have bravery of 10.
Oh.
Flamers just appear on the walls. Mystic shield from the warlock into the hell pit.
Does not fails.
The pack master's gonna whip the hell pit
into
frenzy.
I don't have to roll anything.
I get it on a 1+ on 2 guys. He is frenzied. Going on to the moon phase, first of all, the Warpfire Thor is staring down at my Phoenix Guard. I'm moving forward. Running the Helmet Abomination, he's going to move 10 inches. Deathmaster is just jumping on the barrels, getting ready to charge up at the Bolt Thrower. Running the Flamers.
Good.
So he's moved 9, so they're going to get another 6 inches on their run, so they're moving 15 inches. And they fly, so just flying on top of the little wall here. Warlord's going to run 10 inches. 10 inches. Engineer's going to run 8 inches.
This guy is going to run.
Going to run that warplane cannon.
Not bad, 10 inches.
They're pushing and just rolling downhill real fast. Spinner! He's going to move 12.
He's the smartest guy in my army.
He's way back. Like, nope, I'm not doing any of the fighting. And running the Packmaster 12 as well. Those gates are about to get crashed through with a big old pile of rat flesh, whatever that thing is. 3 flamers are going to have 10 shots into these 2 archers. Hitting on 4s. Wounding on 3s. 6 up saves. Now they're dead.
Yeah.
Warp fire thrower down there is going to fire into my Phoenix Guard.
Pumping for flame.
More, no one. Oh, now D6 more wounds.
3.
3 more you wounds.
You get a 4 up.
Ignoring more wounds on a 4 up. Hey, they all survive.
Bathe.
Now she's going to throw throwing stars at the archers. Hitting on 3s. Wounding on 4s. 2 wounds. Save. Nope, 2 die. I'm going to pull these 2. Oh, if I can get them up there. Prince Hell tail attack from the Deceiver into the archers. Misses. Then his Doomstar is going to throw into the Spearman. Hits 3s. On a 3. That's a hit. Wounds on a 3. That's a wound.
Minus 1 run.
6 up save. No. Lose Spearman. I reroll 1s and 2s.
D3.
D3. Ouch. 3. I don't need a trumpet no more. And I don't need this guy. Or this guy, I guess. Flamers is each going to fire next. 3 of them are going to fire at my archers. Hitting on 4s. Wounding on 3s. And 6 up save. 3 go through for D3.
Oops.
It doesn't matter which ones you use. They're all dead. That kills the remaining 4 archers.
The rest onto the
spearmen. Hitting on 4s. Wounding on 3s. 5 up save. Rerolling 1s and 2s. That's going to be D3 apiece, and it doesn't really matter because that's all I have left. They're all dead. Charge time. Deathmaster's going to declare a charge. Deathmaster's getting a 6-inch. And puts him up top onto my bolt thrower. Deceiver's going to charge too. Six inches. Getting in. The Deceiver's going to pile in towards my mage, but staying on the anointed, and then attacking my mage. 3s and 4s to hit. Or 3s to hit, 4s to wound, is what I'm trying to say.
I said the same thing.
Yeah. 2 wounds on mage, so no save, and a D3 apiece. Oh, 1 left. 1 wound left. Okay. Brings my mage down to 1. Alright, so my two crewmen are trying to kill Deathmaster here. Hitting on 4s. Wounding. Oh, they're hitting on 3s because the thing's in play. Wounding on 4s.
No, the thing isn't that. Yeah.
The chant was still in play for them, so we got. Didn't matter, I hit on 4 anyway. So we got 1 wound on him. With a
failed save, you got him.
I killed. You go, guys. My anointed attacks next. He has 4 attacks, hitting the Deceiver on 2s, because the chant. Oh, they're all 3s. Anyway, they all hit.
Yeah.
Wounding on 3s. We got 3 wounds, minus 1.
Got 5s.
Oh yeah! He's still alive. My mage attacks next. He has 1 attack, normally hitting on 4s, but 3s because that was I chanted on my last turn. 3s to hit. 3's the wound.
Did you get it? I can't
see. Yep. Is a Ren, so 5 up save.
No.
The mage knocks him out with his staff. Knocked the head right off. And that ends turn 4, going on to turn 5. She's gonna go first. 3. No! Skaven turn 5. That general's gonna summon some more flamers, getting 2d6 from the trait from the scenario, and 7 more appear.
A bunch of
flamers just appear through the wall. Going right to the movement phase, I think it's all over. So he tried to do more, all good. No hurting himself. And then D6 more wounds on them. 3. Hey, 1 still alive. Let's keep the banner alive. Or when you can time. Strength 2.
Oh, that's where I get that.
Yup, so now rolling 6 dice. Every 2 plus the mortal wound. So 5 mortal wounds. 5, 4 plus saves for that lone. No, he's dead. There they all go. Now, I think you guys know why nobody's really moving, because once these guys shoot into my archers and they're dead, there's no way the elves can win. So we're going to roll for formality, but looks like we have a Skaven victory. Bunch of shots hitting on fours. Three's the wound. And that's going to wipe them out. They're all D3 wounds apiece, and there's only six of them there. So that's it. The elves are forced from their keep and out of the town. With the Skaven Warlord's major victory, he rolls on the triumph table, and he will always have... Inspired. You can reroll all your failed hit rolls in one of your army's combat phases for one unit. Not looking good for the elves of Selenar. The city has fallen. They're going to have to retreat. So next week, the elves are probably going to have to go on the offensive and see if we can start attacking some Skaven and doing something, because they've been pushed right out now that the keep is gone. But we still have the glade in the middle of the town to worry about, sorry, the other part of the town, where the watchtower is. So in the vault last week, we played that scenario, but we're going to continue on with that line and see what happens with the lore master while he holds the gate or the tower. So if you're not already a Vault member, you can click the link below and get yourself a 7-day free trial to watch that battle report. It's just a continuation from the part two, mission two from last week. But it's going to be Battle Plan, the Ritual. Join us in the Vault. Thanks for watching and happy wargaming.